Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So, it's been a while since I've posted on this channel, but I thought, I was talking to Tamar from I Thrift Shit on Instagram, and she was planning on starting her own vlogging channel here on YouTube, and we're talking about using the iPhone, the new iPhone as the vlogging camera, and I was telling her, actually, it works really well, la 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 la, because that's what I use when I'm out and about. I don't carry this mirrorless camera, even though it's quite small. The microphone is quite obnoxious and it's pretty obvious that I'm filming. I only would carry this if I'm actually with somebody else, but if I'm going out alone, I use my iPhone with my earphones for the microphone because it's less awkward and it kind of disguises the whole thing as if I was just video calling with a mate, right? So anyway, I wanted to start this off and show you, well, as you can probably see here, this is my workstation. I've got my makeup there, some of my makeup there. The other ones are there at the bottom in a bag. But this is actually my workstation because I work from home. I work for an education company that does programming boot camps, and I am a career advisor or a career services manager is what my technical role is. But I work from home, everything is done online, all the calls are done via Zoom, so I don't really have to be at the school, which is comfortable for me. I don't have to travel and stuff like that. So yeah, this is my workstation. It's our spare bedroom that isn't being used at the moment, so unless we have guests, this is going to be my office, okay? And I wanted to do an OOTD for you guys as well. So as you would have seen in my previous videos, I have transitioned, or I am transitioning to being more of a secondhand consumer. And that's more conscious in a sense, because I find that everything that I need has already been made, and it's out there in circulation already. So I don't really advocate for buying fast fashion anymore, especially if you're not gonna get your cost per wear. I don't, even when I wasn't a secondhand consumer, I veered away from those really cheap, like Forever 21 kind of clothing where you can tell that the material and the craftsmanship was not done in the best way. My fast fashion favorite places used to be H&M, Uniqlo, and Zara, but I don't buy from them anymore. I don't even remember the last item that I bought from them. And if you've been following my journey here on YouTube, you know that I started off as a beauty channel, doing all of these makeup tutorials, hauls, and reviews, which in the last maybe 2 years or so, I haven't done very much of. And that's mainly because I don't buy new makeup anymore. I don't wear makeup that much because I do work from home now. Even when I was working more in the corporate world, worked in a school, I didn't really wear much makeup at all. So I didn't see the use of buying new makeup and then having it, you know, just hoarding it. So I've given away quite a few of them, sold quite a few of them, especially the ones that have not even been opened. And yeah, so anyway, that's long blubbering. But yeah, I'm actually going to link down below my video of why I transitioned from fast fashion to slow fashion to give you a better idea of why I do this now. And I've also, I think I've made one or two videos of me thrift shopping. But yeah, so let's get on with the OOTD. The top, this is a knit top from Zara that I got off of Vinny's in Glebe. That is a charity shop, or how we call it here in Australia, is called op shop or opportunity shops. So secondhand Zara. The dress, this beautiful 100% cotton dress that makes me think that I'm a schoolgirl, is by a company called Woolrich, which I think is a British brand if I'm not mistaken. And I paid $39 for this, which I think if I had bought this firsthand would have cost me at least $120, considering the quality of the craftsmanship, the quality of the material, the fact that it's 100% cotton. Yeah, so $39 for this dress is not bad at all. The shirt, I believe this was $8 or $10 if I'm not mistaken. Shoes are old Converse. I've had this for 5 years now. They've been serving me well. Just this plain white ones. Jewelry, I'm gonna take this off. This is just a clip on. This is a, come on, focus. There we go. This is a second hand, look at how pretty that is. Pair of clip-on earrings that I got off of Salvo's in Chatswood. This was $2. Okay. On my fingers is my wedding ring. This watch is by Marc Jacobs, marked by Marc Jacobs. I've had it for 6 years. Okay. The other hand has my engagement ring. Okay. And then on around my neck, you can see that, stop it, is a necklace with my monogram necklace with our initials D and M, which is Duncan and Meg. This was from 2012. We had it custom made when we were in the Middle East. So, yeah. That's my OOTD for today. There we go. Yeah, so I also have a Depop and an eBay shop where I sell some of the things that I have bought and that I don't use, whether it's I bought it firsthand or secondhand. I do have a few bags on there, which when I bought, I thought were authentic. They were either thrifted from the op shops or bought from the weekend markets here. But after thorough scrutiny and having it authenticated, found that they were not real. So what I've done is I've put them on my Depop and my, my eBay. And I'm going to link those two in the description down below just in case you guys are interested. Because while they are not authentic designer bags, because I've got a Louis Vuitton, Burberry, and two Gucci bags on there. While they're not authentic, they are real leather. So they're still good quality. They're just not real, according to the brands. They're probably made by the same factories that they use. Just didn't pass the quality control and stuff like that. Anyway, I'm gonna link that down below because what I plan to do is after this video, I'm going to film my bag collection, most of which are branded items. Actually, all of them are branded items. I'm gonna film that video. But I'm only going to show you the ones that I'm keeping. I'm not going to show you the ones that are on my Depop and eBay. And then the next thing that I'm going to... I made a secondhand shoes video on here. But I have accumulated a few since then. So I'm going to make an updated video on that. But I will also not include the shoes that I plan on selling. Yeah. So, I guess that's it. This is already like a 9-minute video of me talking nonsense. Anyway, I'm also going to link Tamar's Instagram on here, iThriftShit. You can go ahead and check her out. She's based in Amsterdam and she's got fashion sense. All right, I'll see you all again in the next video. Look out for it. It's going to be a bag video. Bye.